are in the world. This is Sweet Willie Teabag on WFTDA-TV, and I'm joined by the...
Mellow Joe. Great to be here, Willie.
Thanks, Joe. It's great to be here as well. And we've got what could be the matchup of the day, although some people that sat and watched the Tampa-Nashville bout that just went on might say different, because it was a good one. It was a barn burner. But this one, number six against number three, a rapidly improving number six, Atlanta Roller Girls, the Dirty South Derby Girls, going up against Houston.
Oh, that's right. And Houston, of course, seeded higher in this one. But Atlanta, like you said, it's a great point. They've been making a lot of adjustments this season, and it's a lot different team than we would have seen in the tournaments last year. Of course, Atlanta, 2 years in a row, have been eliminated by Nashville. So they're hoping this year, this is their year to get that third place spot. Or you know, obviously everybody wants the top spot, but anyone will take a trip to the championship, that's for sure.
Absolutely, especially when they're in Atlanta this year. And nothing like being there in front of their home crowd. The first time they can punch their ticket to the championships could be, you know, this year. Wouldn't that be a great feeling for this team? So they've prepared well, and I don't think they expected to be as good as they are at this point, but they got three additions during the season that really, really changed the team, really filled in some holes that they needed. We'll talk a little bit more about them as the bout goes on. Of course, you've got Wild Cherry, who came out of Gotham, who brought some good veteran experience. I mean, she was a star in Gotham, but she really brought some glue to the team. Like, you know, can't say that she, one skater does not make a team, but one skater can certainly make a difference. She was one of them. You'll also see Jammunition, which gave them some tremendous speed and agility on the jam line, which we didn't see before with Atlanta. So your teams are almost ready to go. I'm going to run through the Atlanta roster very quick. They're in red today. You got number 1013, Holicidal. 12 a.m., Rebel Yellow. 1979, The Ruffian. 1 pound, The Merchant of Menace. 2 pound, you, Queen Luz Jatifa. 32, Belle of the Brawl. Number 50, Jammunition. Number 6, Wild Cherry. 73, Alas Insane. Number 747, Ozzy Kamikaze. Number 762, Scout Sniper. Number 89, 79, Switchblade Susie. Number 99, No Regrets. And X13, Agent Maldher.
And quickly trying to run through the... Well, we're in the action here. Maybe in a timeout we can run through the Houston roster. But look at this. Atlanta off to a great start here.
With Merchant of Menace going around the outside, getting lead jammer very quickly. Meanwhile, Brandy Brown struggling a little bit with Queen Luz Jatifa, Wild Cherry, and Switchblade Susie. If they've locked her down on the inside, forcing her now to the outside, Cherry's out there with her all over the track. Meanwhile, Merchant of Menace running into the Houston Roller Girls and able to get through and put a grand slam, a natural grand slam, on the board early, just what Atlanta wanted. Meanwhile, Brandy Brown getting through there, Joe. What's she doing now?
Now, well, we got both of the jammers on their scoring run, but it's all Atlanta right now.
And Merchant gets driven to the inside. Oh, calls it off as she was going down on her backside. With 29 minutes to go in this first half, it's a 6-0 start for Atlanta.
And this time Houston's putting up Beverly Kills, number 9021.
And Holicidal, number 1013. Holicidal, an addition from last year to this team, and a tremendous, tremendous athlete. She can play all the positions. And she gets shoving in there right away off the line. Beverly Kills, meanwhile, running into Wild Cherry. Cherry forces her out of bounds. She has to reset, and Holicidal is through.
Holicidal able to find that space there in the inside of turn three. Took full advantage of that. Beverly Kills, meanwhile, still stuck behind a two-wall.
Switchblade Susie and Alas Insane working over nicely, and Holicidal gets the natural grand slam. There's another 5 points for Atlanta. Two jams dominating the pack so far, Joe.
Atlanta is off to a great start. Certainly looking like a dominant team, but we are very, very early in this one.
That's right. Nothing like settling down those jitters. And away you go. Although in that last bout, we saw that 30-point power jam in the first jam held up the whole game.
Kind of set the tone for the rest of the bout.
It did. So the team in red with Holicidal jamming pulls up 10 more points. 16-0 Atlanta. Two jams in. 27 minutes, 39 seconds to go.
We've got Death by Chocolate as the jammer for Houston in this one.
Merchant of Menace with her second trip to the line. Of course, she scored five in the first round.
Houston is 1-3 against Atlanta in the playoffs.
Yes, and these teams have met. They haven't met in the last couple of years. So a lot of changes to both teams. Interesting to see what happens here. Both teams playing nice defense. However, Death by Chocolate getting through, but she's got one to beat a Scout Sniper, able to get around the outside of Scout.
Both the jammers out of the pack there, very tight.
Death by Chocolate got the lead jam call, but Merchant of Menace snuck down the inside and got in front of her with a nice little pump.
And she's going to call this one, not going to take any risks here. Let's just reset, she says.
So if you're not going to get lead jammer, that's what you do, what Merchant did, track that jammer down and make her call it off.
And we've got Jamunition this time jamming for Atlanta.
Number 50, one of the key additions to this team. Tremendous speed. Watch the moves on this skater. Number 50 in the red for Atlanta, Jamunition. 26 minutes, 22 seconds to go in this first half.
And Miss Dilla for Houston.
She runs into Mulder right away, trying to get an assist from one of her teammates there. They can't break that red wall, so Jam uses some of those fancy moves, and she is your lead jammer. Adjusts her helmet, and away she goes. Meanwhile, Ozzy Kamikaze, Agent Mulder, Wild Cherry, and Switchblade Susie are locking down Miss Dilla right now, Joe.
Atlanta is looking really, really good in these first handful of jams here.
Very tight in that pack. Miss Dilla nowhere to go. She's got three blockers again in front of her. Susie or Cherry knocking her out of bounds, and she's got to reset. In the meantime, Jamunition, one step away from a grand slam. She calls it off. I believe she got the four, though. Let's see what they put up on the board.
Miss Dilla was never able to get any traction in the pack there. Just completely shut down by Atlanta.
No, and she had someone right in front of her at one point in time trying to break down that wall, but Atlanta was able to engulf both those skaters. Fantastic pack
swarmed
play.
Swarmed them.
Exactly. 25 minutes to go. Atlanta up 21-0. Atlanta in the red. Houston in the black.
Randy Brown now jamming this time for Houston back on the jammer line.
She's up against No Regrets, who's getting worked over by Wendigo. Wendigo, of course, I think is the only Canadian playing in this tournament from my home country of Canada. In the meantime, Brandy Brown gets driven to the inside, but she is able to tightrope down and get lead jam first time for Houston today.
I know some of our Canadian friends are watching, so we'd like to give them a shout out today. They know what it's all about.
A big shout out. Mellow Joe's been up there announcing in Canada with me at the World Cup. Made lots of Canadian friends there, I'm sure. In the meantime, No Regrets. Finally able to get to the front of that pack and free. However, Brandy Brown on her second pass through. And she gets three. If she calls it off in turn number three.
And that's going to crack the goose egg for Houston, finally on the board now.
That's right, but Atlanta, although they struggled in that first pass, then tightened up the defense and only allowed her to get three. Merchant of Menace on the line for the third time, going up against Beverly Kills. 9-0-2-1. Don't say the O.
The O comes when she smacks into somebody.
That's
and they
right.
say, oh.
Ah, and everybody kind of tried to go to the pivot line there. We still got our jammers away immediately. Both of them trying the outside line. Nothing going there. So Merchant of Menace now on her own against that wall of Houston. And she beats it. And look at the leaning that's going on. Two Atlanta blockers literally leaning on Beverly Kills. One on each shoulder, and she could not move in that pack. Merchant of Menace.
Just made a sandwich out of her.
Exactly, old Malachi crunch from the Happy Days days. Merchant of Menace with a grand slam on the board. And she's going for another rotation here. Why not? Kills is still getting dominated by that Houston defense. There's Kamikaze. There's Wild Cherry. Almost took her out on the inside, but she's still going. In the meantime, Merchant of Menace has engaged the Houston defense, and she is able to step aside, but as she puts one wheel out of bounds, calls it off.
That's going to do it for this jam. Atlanta Seven jams in, looking really good right now. They've got 30 points. Houston at 3.
I believe Houston's calling a timeout to maybe settle themselves down and figure something out.
Yeah, that's a good call by the coach, I think. It's probably time to take a break and just trying to make some adjustments here.
That's right. Houston's a good team. This lead's not going to last for a while. They're going to pound back very, very hard. But sometimes you got to settle down your team and say, okay, whoa. You know, we're here. We're a good team. Let's play our game. That's
the
whatever
old,
I think we're
take
seeing.
A deep breath and count to 10.
Right. Let's get back in it. But Atlanta got to have some confidence right now. They're playing very, very well. And in turn, they got to be saying to themselves, hey, this is how we got to play our game. Play it like this, and we're going to be fine.
Meanwhile, we'd like to thank Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, Rydell.
And I saw you earlier sliding through those corners, Mellow Joe, when you were warming up. I think you need yourself a pair of radar wheels. They have the new Radar Villain Wheel. Go see them, radarwheels.com. 22 minutes, 43 seconds to go. 30-3 Atlanta. Holicidal going up against number 16, Mistilla. Yeah, nobody in the penalty box right now. Holicidal pushing and shoving. Mistilla digging in, doing the push cart, but she goes down in a heap of people.
Traffic jam in turn one as everyone takes a spill.
Holicidal able to do it, but nice recovery by Mistilla. Holicidal got her hips in front of that final skater, got lead jammer status, but then got recycled a little bit back into the pack.
That's definitely one of those jams where I don't envy the jam refs because, you know, from our vantage point, it can be pretty difficult to tell, and I wouldn't want to be the guy that has to make that call.
That's right, because it's got to happen in a split second. We have a little bit of time to think. We can unplug the feed here and let the fans, you know, plug it back in so the fans have a little delay so we can sound smart. But those referees are making those calls instantly. Merchant of Menace up against Death by Chocolate. Menace having a great first half. She's rolled up 15 points so far, but she is struggling with Wendigo right now at the back of the pack.
But it's Death by Chocolate in turn two. She's the lead jammer on the inside there. Nice move.
Only the second lead jam tonight for Houston. This is what they need, and this is what they probably talked about during the timeout. But she's got a four wall of Atlanta that drives her to the outside. She tries the middle, calls it off, got one, got her hips in front of one. So Houston's got four now with 21 minutes, 24 seconds to go. And Jam Munition on the line. Of course, Jam rolled up 5 points in her initial jam of the evening. And she's up against Beverly Kills.
Beverly Kills, look, you can see her breathing here, like, I almost think maybe it wouldn't hurt to have an extra jammer in the rotation here for Houston.
That's a great point, Joe, because they've been having to work so hard in there, and that pushing and shoving, I think, is more exhausting on these skaters than just skating at a high speed.
Oh, and it certainly is, more so than you can kind of convey just by watching it on your screen there.
That's right. They train their legs so much. But you get into that pack and you got to use that upper body and push and shove and dig in, and you can wear out yourself very, very easily. So Jam Munition, with approximately 30 feet of track between her and Beverly Kills, enters that pack, jives around three skaters, and it's 33-4 with 20 minutes to go in the first half.
That was a nice move there. Just pick up those 3 points, put them in the bank, save them for later. They may need them, but right now, they've got a 29-point lead.
Brandy Brown, number 26 on the line for Houston in the black, up against No Regrets, number 99 in the red. Brown with 3 out of those 4 points for Houston when she got that one lead jam. And the pack does not move. These girls got to push and shove a little bit harder.
Look at that Atlanta wall. They are just impenetrable right now.
They are. They are pushing each other, doing a great job. But, there's going to be a low block penalty there on someone who's getting up very, very slowly. It's Wild Cherry, I believe.
Meanwhile, Houston has the lead jam. That's Brandy Brown, your lead jammer.
And there was no penalty called there. No Regrets still working on that pack. She's struggling with that defense, but Brandy Brown with her second lead jam of the evening. And she's looking for some points, but there's that Atlanta defense as Cherry drives her out of bounds, makes her reset. But No Regrets struggling with number 1491, Wendigo.
I have to say I'm pretty impressed with the amount of defense that Atlanta is able to put up here today, it's a very different team from the team we saw in Kansas City last year.
Correct. And like I said, the extra three cogs they put in their on their team this year have made a gigantic difference. Nora, one to beat before she gets through. But this is a great jam for Brandi Brown in Houston. And she's going for a little bit more. But Wild Cherry eyeing her, bumps her, shoves her, gets an assist from her, one of her teammates. And finally, Brown has to call it off as she spins around on her back two wheels.
Trying to avoid that track cut, I think, there in turn one. They bumped her out of bounds, and she almost came back in. She was thinking about it, and she was like, no, better just call this one.
That's right.
We'll call it a day.
Smartly, 35-12. Nice eight-point jam for Houston. Just what they needed with 18 minutes to go. Atlanta in the red with Queen Lujatifa on the right. Alas Insane, the president of the WFTDA, in the middle. And that looks like number 92 on the left, Belle of the Brawl, one of the best derby faces in the business.
Death by Chocolate jamming this one out for Houston.
And she's run into that three wall right away. However, Merchant of Menace getting nowhere as number 22, Freight Train, drives the train over her and out of bounds. Queen Lujatifa up there and out of nowhere down the inside.
Wow.
Jammer.
That was just in the nick of time, too, because Death by Chocolate also broke out of the pack almost simultaneously.
So Chocolate hit her as Menace went careening out of bounds. She called that jam off. But fantastic defense on both teams there. Although the jammers got through almost simultaneously, it was not easy by any stretch. 17 minutes to go in this half, 35-12 Atlanta. Beverly Kills on the line for Houston. Hollis Seidel for Atlanta in the red. And the whistle has blown, but since nobody took a knee,
there it is. Beverly Kills trying to go on the inside there, now to the outside.
Wild Cherries all over her.
Hollis Seidel trying to take the outside now to the inside. That worked out a little bit better there in turn two as she becomes lead jammer.
You notice Hollis Seidel has a very upright skating style, but still generates tremendous power and tremendous speed and able to see the track very well because of her height and her upright skating style. She calls it off and puts three on the board. 41-12, Atlanta in the lead.
Yeah, you know, that's a great point that you make about that upright skating style. You know, a lot of times we see our speed skaters with that low stance, but that upright style does give you an eye in the sky, if you will. I mean, you've got a little bit better view of the way things are playing out on the track at any given time.
That's right, and you'll see a lot of those speed skaters having to slow down as they enter the pack and stand up to be able to see something, whereas Hollis Seidel is able to have that view the whole way around, her and skaters like that have that upright skating style.
We've got Brandi Brown jamming this one for Houston.
She's the leading scorer for Houston. She's up against the leading scorer for Atlanta, Merchant of Menace. Both of them pushing and shoving, but there is a three wall for Houston shutting her down, shutting Merchant down. And in the black, going nowhere is Brandi Brown as Rebel Yellow takes her out. Last and Same and Belle the Brawl then reset and try to work her to the outside, but she's able to get around. One to beat at Scout Sniper. And Brandy still struggling with it. In the meantime, approaching the pack for points is Merchant of Menace. She's looking for some help. She's got 1 point. She's got her hips in front of another for two, and she's going for the four, but Houston tightening up in turn number three. And now Atlanta has recycled the jammer back into the pack. That gives Menace a chance for a grand slam here, Joe, but she, in turn, gets hit and has to start this all over again.
Yeah, Menace, although she got out of the pack first, was waved off as lead. But, you know, right now it really doesn't matter because her blockers are doing a great job.
That's correct. Now, also having said that, Houston has locked her down, and I think she has got a couple points in there but been recycled back into the pack and still has not completed a full scoring pass.
She takes a spill there in turn two. And now she finally gets out of there, and it's five in the sky and a grand slam for Merchant of Menace.
43-12 for Atlanta, 14 minutes to go, 21 seconds on the jam clock, and finally getting the lead jammer call. Just as Menace got into the pack, did she sneak out? She got another one in there. and it's 45-12. I guess it doesn't get much better than that when you don't have lead jammer status and you're able to score 5-6 points.
Yeah, when the track gives you lemons, you make lemonade, and that's what she did.
Yeah,
right,
and
there.
The lemons were, I think the lemons were squeezed by the defense of Atlanta.
Because <They were.
laughs> they had the squeeze on Brandy Brown. And who we got now? Mistilla up against Jamunition, who has earned the nickname Grand Slam Jamunition. Because of her speed and quickness, she has rolled up a whole lot of points on Grand Slams in Atlanta this year.
Well, and that speed and quickness that you mentioned there, she is back around to the back of the pack now already.
You'll notice Wild Cherry with the takeout of Mistilla, but took the out-of-play major. But Mistilla did turn back and came back in the pack.
And we got both jammers on their scoring run, but she calls it. Jamunition picking up 5 points on that one.
And interesting, even though Wild Cherry took out Mistilla and took an out-of-play penalty, Mistilla skated back into the pack and actually got lapped, and that ended up the Grand Slam came from. And a little bit of old-school derby, although they're taking a knee, they're on the pivot line.
The old pivot line, our old friend.
Yeah.
How you doing?
Well, Merchant of Menace going up against Beverly Kills. Now, they don't move off that pivot line. And what a spin move by
nice
Beverly
move.
Kills.
Love the agility there. I wish I could do that.
You told me earlier that you could. Maybe that was late night Lyle. I don't know. One of you two guys has a great spin move. All right, Beverly Kills ready to enter that pack on her scoring pass. Merchant of Menace still struggling, but she's got one to beat now. However, Beverly Kills with a great chance to get some points for Houston with 12 minutes to go in this first half. She hits the pack in turn number 4. Alas Insane, Bella the Brawl, and Rebel Yellow with Alas Insane, the president of WFT Day with a big hit. Takes her out. So 2 points, and she calls it off smartly as Merchant of Menace was flying up into that pack. I wonder if Merchant of Menace is wearing Adam Wheels, a proud partner in the official wheel of the WFTDA, adamwheels.com. 11 minutes, 34 seconds to go in this half. 49-14 for Houston.
Hollis Idol, the jammer for Houston.
And number 9, Big Bad Voodoo Dolly. This is her first jam of the evening. A compact, powerful skater. And she is pushing as hard as she can on Switchblade Susie and the rest of the Dirty South Derby girls. They drive her out of bounds. And Hollis Idol,
trying to find that path there on the outside. Kind of stuck in the center now.
So Switchblade Susie comes up and drives a big shoulder into number 22 Freight Train. That helps Hollis Idol. She's finally able to get through. And Susie and the rest of Atlanta turn their attention to number 9, Big Bad Voodoo Dolly. And here comes that crushing defense. And right on cue, they drive her to the outside. She finally is able to get around. Hollis Idol calls it off. Interesting. I don't know how many points she got. No, she got the full 4. Now, that was some great awareness, Joe. I didn't think Holly got in front of all the Houston skaters, but she did. She got recycled back and called it immediately. Smart play.
Well, we had one blocker in the box as well, and the box now filling up as that jam ends.
With 10 minutes to go, 53-14. And a 2-on-2 pack, so we'll put 2 red, Bella the Brawl, and Ozzy Kamikaze for Atlanta up front. They're facing Wendigo and number 16, Mistilla, in this 2-on-2 pack. So you put out 2 fast skaters, Jamunition and Brandy Brown. This is going to be a...
They can try for a speed option here.
I'd say. And that's what they're doing as they blow down the inside, but Jam goes to the outside and gets beat by Mistilla. But Jamunition trying to track her down.
Both of these jammers going very fast right now. Atlanta keeping the heat on, trying to force them to call it off here.
And look at the speed of that pack. It's probably tough to see on the WFTA.TV feed. Because they are moving so fast, but those jammers are having trouble catching that pack. Now they do, both on the scoring pass. Mastilla, however, getting those 4 points. Brandy Brown, pardon me, getting those 4 points. Jamunition has to reset. And she is finally through, but she gets knocked out of bounds and has to go back in there. Referee's asking for her to pack it back up again. Brandy Brown, the standout, looking for some more points for Houston. Exactly what they need with 8 minutes and 36 seconds to go in this half.
She's staring down these four Atlanta blockers right now. That's no easy task to get by these girls.
Wow, Cherry driving her out of bounds. Nice move, calls it off.
A grand slam and four. Both teams picking up some points there. Houston coming out a little better in that jam.
57 to 23 as they close the gap slightly with 8 minutes to go. If you're listening to us on the free audio cast for only $12, you can update to the high def feed, WFTDA.TV. Beverly Kills and Holocidal. Holocidal in the red for Atlanta, Kills in the black for Houston, and Kills gets knocked out of bounds by Switchblade Susie, who waves her arms in the air and says,
and Holocidal on the outside of turn two is the lead jammer.
And another great takeout back there by Atlanta.
Goes to the inside again. Not as much luck this time, though, as she is in a four-person, four-way sandwich there.
Switchblade Susie can only slow up Beverly Kills so long. Holocidal tried. Did she get any points? She got the four. Holocidal. Talk about a battle, Joe. You pointed it out.
She had to work for those 4 points.
But again, great
she
presence.
She earned them.
She figures out. She gets her hips in front of all four. And even if she gets recycled back into that pack.
Yep, you still got them. They're in the bank.
It's right. And she knows when to call it off. Hey, I got them. I'm done. And away we go. Merchant of Menace on the line against Mastilla. We've seen these two a couple times tonight. Menace, the leading scorer for the Dirty South Derby girls right now in red. Menace pushing and shoving, but so is Mastilla. She, however, has run into Wild Cherry in the pivot position. A little bit of space there for Menace. Menace gets driven to the inside on the back straightaway, and finally, with an OPAC situation, gets through.
That spread out pack really, really helped out Merchant of Menace there.
That's right. I don't know if it was intentional or not, because they'd all had their eyes turned on Mastilla, or the bulk of the pack did. And there is another natural grand slam for Merchant of Menace. She is rolling up the points in this half. And there she goes again down the inside. Merchant of Menace, five more with the defense for Atlanta locking down Mastilla. And look at Wild Cherry at the back, battling with Windigo, but still able to get a hip onto Mastilla so she can't go anywhere.
Menace now jukes to the inside. Now trying to find a path down the center. And turn four now.
Atlanta doing a great job of taking jammers out of bounds and then skating backwards to force them to come back in as far as possible backwards on the track.
And that's five in the sky, and another grand slam for Merchant of Menace, adding five more to the score of Atlanta.
And she is going to be in the nightmares of Houston tonight, I believe, along with Wild Cherry. That's a whole lot of grand slams that Menace has put on the board. 36 points right now for her, half of the Atlanta total. But Menace gets taken out there by Death by Chocolate. And they're doing a nice job of locking her down now. I think exhaustion is starting to set in with 11 seconds to go in this jam and 5 minutes in this half. Menace straddling that line, looking back and saying, all right, let's let this one run out. There's the end of the jam.
And she picked up four more right there at the end, squeaked them in. Of course, they're still scoring points until that fourth whistle blast, and she took every advantage there with that fourth whistle blast. Picked up about a point per whistle blast.
If you're going to do it. And that's one of the struggles you get in is when you've got the four wall lined up. All a skater's got to do is really gain 5 feet if you're all lined up across the floor like that. She gets around one, she gets around all, and she gets those 4 points.
And our next jam is underway. Beverly Kills jamming this one for Houston.
And Jamunition.
And Jamunition on the outside of turn two, getting battered and bruised here.
And there was the two Houston skaters that collided heavily together as they hit Jamunition.
And so while she was successfully recycled to the back, Beverly Kill simultaneously bolts out of the front of the pack.
And one of the beautiful things about this sport is how these girls are able to play offense and defense simultaneously. And there she goes, Beverly Kills, five. And with Kills coming around one more time, 3 minutes, 28 seconds to go, 80 to 28 for Atlanta. And she gets driven out of bounds by Agent Mulder, who skates to the back of the pack, forces her in, but Jamunition still got nowhere to go against that Houston defense. This is the tightest they've played all bout, Joe.
We've got a spill there.
That was interesting. Hollis Seidel and Beverly Kills colliding at the back of the pack, almost skating the wrong way on the track. Interesting little collision.
And Jamunition finally makes her way out of the pack here.
And Beverly Kills gets through for four more, calls it off just as Jamunition's ready to hit the pack.
Well, let's make that five.
And that makes it a 33 for Houston, but 80 still for Atlanta. And it's good to see Houston getting somebody else free and getting some points. It really have been all Brandy Brown up to this point. And the Green Monster, makers of Antic, Gumball, Toe Stops, Heartless Wheels, Reckless Wheels, and Moto Bearings. Green Monster just doesn't give you great derby products. They give you confidence.
You can check them out online, grnmnstr.com.
And speaking of confidence, that's what Atlanta has right now, and they easily get the Merchant of Menace through that pack. However, finally through the pack, number 26 in the black, Brandy Brown. The leading score for Houston, but Merchant of Menace around the outside untouched. Well, you got a 4-on-2 pack, Joe. That makes your life a lot easier, doesn't it?
It certainly does. It certainly does. You know, it doesn't make anything impossible, because as long as you've got those blockers there, if they time it just right, you can kind of get your jammer through there. But, yeah, certainly life is a lot easier when the numbers are on your side, no doubt.
So Queen Lujatifa doing a little cougaring back there, taking her an intentional minor and clearing her slate of penalties. Number 69, Death by Chocolate, up against Hollis Seidel. We've seen Chocolate jam a few times tonight. She's only been able to put 1 point on the board for her team.
Almost picked up a false start there.
But everybody's okay. Everybody's clear. And walking slowly to that pivot line, Dirty South Derby girls in the red, Houston in the black with 55 seconds to go. Here comes Hollis Seidel and Death by Chocolate. Houston, of course, getting another number 22 freight train back on the track, so they've got some blockers now to help Chocolate out.
Freight train pulls into the station.
Yes, she does, and there's a nice little jammer on jammer hit, Death by Chocolate, and then she's
nice.
Energized by that.
Hip whip there in the front straightaway, and she's the lead jammer. Nice move there.
She took out Hollis Seidel and then just exploded into that pack and took that hip whip.
Doing some textbook derby to get the lead.
And that's what the Houston needs right now, to get back to the basics. Textbook derby. Hollis Seidel still battling in there. However, Death by Chocolate looking for the four.
And there you go.
And do we get the thumb for the five? Yes, we do. She made the pass on Hollis Seidel, a grand slam. We've seen a whole lot of natural grand slams today.
We sure have. We sure have. I think that's a we've seen some excellent blocking in regard to the blockers helping their own jammers out here. And I think that's been a contributing factor to these grand slams we've seen so far.
Absolutely. They're recycling. They're holding that opposing team's jammer up and making it somewhat easy.
Four more there to the score.
But it's doubled, 84 to 42. Atlanta in the lead as we go to the halftime.
Wow, that went by really fast. I Halftime is already here.
I agree, and I'm sure there's a few people watching at home on WFTDA.TV that feel the same way. That was quick. No, hardly any timeouts. We had one timeout by Houston. No official timeouts.
A lot of fast derby there, too.
And a lot of long jams. It's not like they were – and that's the other thing that keeps it flowing. When you got 1 minute, 45-second jams after jam after jam, that clock disappears rather quickly. So Joe
– if you're Houston, if you're the coach, what adjustments do you make going into the second half?
You really got to analyze what Atlanta's been doing with their blockers, and they've been setting up a great four wall, and they've always had at least one blocker out there that's kind of controlling the blocking. Wild Cherry, for example, playing that power blocker position. You've got to put somebody on that power blocker and get them out of there. Just break down a bit of that Atlanta wall
and try and pick them off,
because Wild Cherry or whomever's playing the power blocker position is engaging immediately, and then Atlanta just surrounds the opposing team's jammer.
That's that swarm. We saw it used very successfully there in the first half. It's like stepping on a nest of bees.
But when Houston is able to beat that power blocker, and then, like you say, you're picking them off. Now you're down to two or three Atlanta blockers. It's very, very different, and that's where they've been successful. So if I'm Houston, that's what I do.
I think that's excellent. And Atlanta, they just have to keep doing what they're doing. It's been successful so far, and if they can continue what they're doing, they really, really looking strong. I have to be frank here. I'm surprised by how well they're dominating Houston right now. I expected a little bit closer game.
And it's all in the pack. All happening in the pack. Excellent, excellent job by Atlanta Dirty South Derby girls. 84-22, Atlanta doubling up on Houston right now. And as Kevin Jensen said on the good old hashtag #TalkToWFTDA, remember #TalkToWFTDA, Kevin Jensen says Atlanta looks like they want an invite to the party they're hosting in November in Atlanta.
I'm inclined to agree with that assessment. I think he's right on the money. And you can tweet us. It's #Talk2WFTDA. We'd love to hear your thoughts on the action as it's unfolding here. Speaking of the action as it's unfolding, Brandy Brown jamming for Houston right now.
Merchant of Menace for Atlanta in the red.
Houston has got to find a way to stop Merchant of Menace. She had 44 points by herself in the first half. And if they can try and slow her down, they might be able to hang in there. But
we're seeing a lot of the same, Joe. Menace through on her scoring pass. And meanwhile, number 26, Brandy Brown, going nowhere in that pack as the swarm that we call the Atlanta defense engulfs her. And she's got now locked down on the last insane and the jammer, Merchant of Menace, and Brandy Brown still struggling to get bounced to the back of the pack behind Queen Lujatifa. The last insane and Wild Cherry. There's five again. And we keep calling it a natural grand slam, Joe, because that's 5 points, but no one in the box, no ghost points. They're doing it the hard way.
They're doing it the hard way, and it deserves a little bit of extra recognition, like that jump right there picks up another 4 points there.
And Merchant of Menace doesn't do those apex jumps very often. When she does, they are exciting, and there it is,
apex,
five more.
Apex jumps are a thing of beauty. They are the slam dunk of our sport.
That's a great way to put it, Mellow Joe. Now, slam dunk. Two more to beat, and she can slam dunk another 5 points in the books here. And out of no pack situation, out of play.
And that's five in the sky, and another grand slam for the Merchant of Menace. She is on fire right now. 14 points in this jam, and she does not look like she's slowing down.
And Brandy Brown tried to slow her down, but could not get a hip into her. Now Brown has to deal with the defense again from Houston, but nice block by number 22, Freight Train. She laid the train into Menace, and she has to finally go over the back of that pack and having a little more trouble on this pass. But when the opposing team jammer is going nowhere,
it does take a little bit of the pressure off when you know that your team has the other jammer trapped pretty well.
And right now you got Ozzy Kamikaze, number 747, doing the splits on that jammer line, and Belle the Brawl laying out flat. They want to own that jammer line.
They're calling dibs on it. They're like the friend that licks all the cookies and says, these are mine. We got here first.
That's right. I'm going to – you know what? I know Ozzy Kamikaze is a good friend of mine, and, yes, she is the friend that licks all the cookies, and I love her for it. Hollis Seidel on the line for Atlanta in the red and in the black, and grabbing lead jammer status quickly. Beverly Kills.
Beverly Kills doing exactly what Houston needs to do in this one. They are lead jammer.
And Wendigo working very hard on Hollis-Eidel, able to slow her considerably, giving Kills lots of room. She puts four on the board and calls it off. I think that's how Houston would have liked to have started the second half with a jam like that. However, Merchant of Menace threw up 15 in that first jam of the second half.
And now Houston sits at 46, Atlanta 98. If you're just joining us in the second half, Atlanta's in red, Houston in black. And thanks for joining us here.
26 minutes, 43 seconds to go in this bout. The winner steps into the winner's bracket and will take on the winner of Kansas City No Coast. There's a whole lot on the line in this bout. And right now, Atlanta doing a fantastic job. Death by Chocolate getting driven to the outside by Queen Lujatif and Belle the Brawl, but she is able to get around them finally. Nice move by Death by Chocolate.
Death by Chocolate is the lead jammer. Just what Houston needs. This is what they need to do. It seems like they've got a little bit of momentum here. Can they keep it up?
And they've actually been able to recycle Merchant of Menace, and with Atlanta turning their attention to defense, Menace is now on her own, and Queen Lujatifa with a little shove of her teammate, who then shoves her back, and that's how they're working on Death by Chocolate. If you can't hit her, I'll help you hit her, and it's working well. But Death by Chocolate, and she got the five. But Merchant of Menace is through, and this is probably going to force the jam to get called off. There it is, Death by Chocolate smartly doing it. But Atlanta still up 104-51 with 25 and a half minutes to go. And you look at the records of these two teams, Joe. Houston 9-4 overall and 5-1 in the region. They had a good run in the region this year, with Atlanta 11-3 overall and 5-2 in the region.
Yeah, their records would indicate that they're fairly evenly matched teams, but right now it is all Atlanta in this one as they pass the 100-point mark.
And Atlanta's been on a six-game winning streak since July, when I said that things really started to come together for this team, and you're seeing them peaking at the right time. Jamunition.
You do see that from time to time. I think London was one of those teams last year where things just start to click, and then all of a sudden they have this unstoppable momentum.
And momentum in sports is worth a lot. Jamunition with a nice little dip and dive and dodge, but she can't get through that Houston defense. However, Freight Train on her first jam for Houston tonight. She is finally through. She's on her scoring pass. Look out. And there's a bit of a change-up. We've seen Freight Train doing a great job in the blocker position. Maybe that's how they deal with the power block and the swarming defense of Atlanta, is put a more power skater in there.
Right. Good luck swarming somebody like Freight Train. She's just going to knock you out of the way.
Exactly. Let's see how that plays out for Houston.
That's a great counter strategy.
It is. And I think we're seeing Houston be a little bit more aggressive in the second half. However, the penalties are still costing them. We got a 4-on-2 pack advantage for Atlanta. Hollis-Eidel on the line against Beverly Kills.
Yeah, you can manage for a jam, but when it becomes consistent, you've just handicapped your team.
That's right. And Kills getting locked down, getting swarmed by that 4 defense. Hollis-Eidel with only 2 to deal with. She's pushing and shoving them along. And she's got a little bit of an opening. She's down the middle, one little bump. There's Hollis-Eidel, lead jammer. In the red, 10-13 on her back, 23 minutes and 30 seconds on the clock.
Hollis-Eidel with 21 points so far today. Looking to add some more to it here.
And there she goes. She's got a couple with one more to beat. She calls it off. I think she got her hips in front. She did. That in phenomenal presence.
And, of course, those free points from the penalty box. She was able to pick up 4 there.
Yep, got her hips in front of that last skater, and there's the 4. 113-51, Atlanta in the red, leading over Houston in the black. Just under 23 minutes to go. Great time to mention PrintCo for your league's printing and promotional needs. Hit up PrintCoGraphics.com. There she is, Merchant of Menace against Death by Chocolate. Chocolate had a good jam last time, and here she goes again.
Nice work on the inside. Oh, but Atlanta now out of the pack.
And Atlanta having a little bit of penalty trouble now as they put 2 in the box on that last jam, and they're at their first pack deficit in a while.
Look at the speed of Merchant just trying to put the heat to her. Forces her to call it off, but I think they both picked up some points here. They did. Atlanta picking up 2. Houston picking up three. They came out just a little bit better, but both teams getting some action there.
And you got Wild Cherry heading to the penalty box, I believe.
And Houston going back to freight train here. Going to try and pull into the station.
Up against Jammunition, we might see some jammer-on-jammer action here. The way Freight Train has been laying people out tonight.
Yeah, she will not hesitate to put a hit on someone.
And she is pushing and shoving to that pack. She's running into Wild Cherry. Great movement on Cherry, but Train gets around her. And here comes the Train down the inside.
Oh, yeah. Turn three, Freight Train is the lead jammer.
Wild Cherry getting up there trying to help out Jammunition. She chips off a block, but there's too many Houston blockers up there, and they are surrounding Jammunition. And the Train is about to pull into the station, Joe, the station being the pack this time. Switchblade Susie bumps her. She bounces off. And she threw for 4 points, calls it off.
A nice work by Freight Train.
What you lose with her by pulling her out of the blocker line seems to be working, because she's able to that initial contact that Atlanta's been so successful with, she's been able to power through it.
Bust through a wall like the Kool-Aid man. Oh, yeah. Houston with 4 points in that one.
Beverly kills on the line. You totally threw me off with that one, Joe, but that's what it was like. That's what you got to do when Atlanta surrounds you like that. Well, we got a timeout on the floor.
Yeah, we'd like to thank the following. The WFTDA.TV partners: Blood and Thunder Magazine, Derbyology, Derbalife, Derby for All, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride Skate Shop, Jammer Up, and Wicked Skatewear. Thank you so much to our WFTDA.TV partners.
And for those of you watching at home, you might be able to see occasionally in the far end of the arena, we got all our vendors set up. A lot of those sponsors have got tables here. There's just a whole lot of Derby in this house right now. Speaking of Derby, Merchant of Menace on the line for Houston, but for Atlanta, but she gets locked down by Houston. And
Beverly Kills was able to make her way through the pack there between turns one and two.
That's the best that Kills has done in a while. But as she was not lead jammer, as soon as Merchant got through, she smartly called it off, and we got no points on the board.
Shut that one down.
As my 5-year-old son Max would say, no points for anyone.
And we'd also like to thank Iron Doll Clothing, custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee, lifting and separating since 2009. Iron Doll Clothing. Visit them online, irondollclothing.com.
Death by Chocolate up against Hollis Idol. Death by Chocolate for Houston, having a nice second half, and she's pushing and shoving here, but so is Hollis Idol. They're both pushing that pack forward. Chocolate utilizes that help from her opposing jammer. As the pack got pushed forward, Chocolate snuck through. Lead jammer status. A 57-point deficit, and the pack slowed to a crawl. Chocolate with a chance to grab 5 points, and it's a power jam as Hollis Idle hens to the penalty box. The high block got her, Joe.
And this is precisely what Houston needs to try and close this gap.
And with a 3-on-2 pack advantage out there, you've only got Bell the Brawl and Alas Insane. And Alas Insane, a fantastic blocker, and as is Bell. Now Atlanta gets their four skaters out there, and they have the pack advantage. But Death by Chocolate, and our first power jam of the bout, she is doing her best to bring Houston back into this one. Two more to beat, but a Switchblade Susie and Bell the Brawl. And Switchblade Susie, now Wild Cherry recycles in there. And with Alas Insane trapped, they got to let her go. The pack was...
Nice work by Houston there.
They had Alas Insane trapped. They got that goat. I never called the WFTDA president Alas Insane a goat, but she was on that one. And Death by Chocolate one more time with 18 minutes and 30 seconds to go. 28 seconds in this jam. Hollis Idol's penalty is almost over. Chocolate through... but not clean.
Forearm's going to send her to the box for a minute, and the power jam shifts to Atlanta.
Now Hollis Idol with a 4-on-3 advantage for her pack, but Houston doing a nice job getting some hips on her, making it difficult. She's got one to beat, but with Atlanta controlling the pack, there's a no pack or out-of-play situation. Hollis Idol does get the 4 points. or pardon me, got no points on that one because that was her initial pass. She took that major penalty on her initial pass, so she never completed it. However, we got the power jam for Jamunition. Atlanta having a huddle on the jam line. So Houston steps up and says, all right, we'll let no pack situation, Joe. We'll let Jamunition get a run at us. That's not the skater I'd want to have a run.
No, I don't know. They're going to take a gamble, I guess. And it's not going to pay off. Jamunition, though, makes her way around the blockers, and she's already lead jammer back at the pack.
And a wall of red, but they let her do it on her own, and she fights in there and pushes and shoves. She's working the outside, then cuts to the inside. One to beat, and with a out of play situation, she's through. Major Wood puts five in his air. There's a grand slam for grand slam Jamunition. And she's going to try it again. Death by Chocolate still taking a seat in that penalty box. So that all those points she rolled up could be erased right here, Mellow Joe. Oh!
That's going to leave a mark.
And that was the old schoolyard thing where someone bent down behind you and somebody else pushed you over top. What a double team. Obviously, the penalty, one penalty going to Houston, but Jamunition a little worse from where. Now with Death by Chocolate out of the penalty box, she's dealing with the defense for Atlanta. She's got fresh legs. She's been sitting for a minute. Jamunition's got 5 points, though.
Five more points, but, you know, she does look a little winded. That took a lot out of her, that spill did.
I'd say it took a lot out of me.
That hurt to watch.
It did.
And she's still going, though. You got to give her credit. I don't know how quick I could get up from something like that.
I think I'd still be down. They'd probably have me on the gurney already, getting wheeled out to the ambulance. So please don't do that to me at the after party. You'll see it having Jamunition going for one more. Of course, we got no lead jammer on this jam, so Jamunition. Oh, but she gets recycled nicely, and there's another big hit. But that's going to cost the low block, the Goldie blocks. She's off. Jamunition getting some love from Queen Luz Yutifa.
The fans here giving a round of applause for that. I think they felt her pain in that one.
How could you not? And with a timeout getting called, it looks like it might be Major Wood and the, or pardon me, timeout by the referees.
Check out the Bracket Bonanza sponsor, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Take 10% off your entire order, 2in1skateshop.com. When you use the coupon code Bonanza during the checkout, 2-in-1 Skate Shop.
And speaking of Bracket Bonanza, there's going to be a trip to the 2013 championships to the winner of Bracket Bonanza from Union Vacations. So get, hopefully, all you folks out there in WFTDA.TV land filled in your brackets and are following nicely. Since we got this timeout, we can also thank the following WFTDA South Central Region playoff partners, specifically for the South Central: Blood and Thunder Magazine, Bones Bearings, Bont Skates, Cruise Skate Shop, Derby for All, Derby Love, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride, 5on5mag.com, Printco, Sin City, Sisu Mouthguards, Vanilla Skates, Viva Las Vegas, and Wicked Skatewear. Big thanks to our partners. And you're seeing the Houston bench right now. Coach Spanky giving them some instruction. That big power jam, all those points they got from Death by Chocolate got erased by Jamunition. And it's still a 53-point differential right now for Atlanta.
And with about 15 and a half minutes left in the bout, that is a very big hill to climb.
Absolutely. Got no regrets on the line. Only the second time she's jammed tonight. She's normally a workhorse jammer for Atlanta. They haven't had to dip in deeply into that rotation, though. So they've got a fresh jammer on the line against Beverly Kills. And Nora blasts through there, showing those fresh legs.
Wow. Very impressive with the speed.
And Nora,
no regrets.
She's got that long stride, just gets a lot of power on to the floor and a lot of speed. She's not going to get the grand slam here. Oh, and she's not going to get that point either. A great takeout by Brandy Brown, who's playing all the positions today for Houston. No regrets. Tries this all over again with the help from Ozzy Kamikaze. She's through. She's waiting, 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 eating every second and calls it off.
Yeah.
Smart play by the veteran.
It was. You could just see it. She was looking back to turn three where Houston's jammer was. And we've just been informed that Goldie Blocks has fouled out of the game. So she will.
And that's, you know, one of the things we talked about, Joe. Houston coming out and playing a little bit more aggressive to try and deal with that defense from Atlanta. And it's cost them in the penalties, cost them with a foul out.
Yep. Goldie Blocks number 007 for Houston.
134 Atlanta, Houston 77, 14 minutes to go. The enemy of Houston now is time, I believe. However, Death by Chocolate, who's had a fantastic, oh, pardon me, that is Freight Train out there.
Freight
who's had
Train.
A couple great jams.
Look, they're trying to swarm her, but she says, don't think so.
That's right.
She goes to the outside in the back straight away, and she's the lead jammer.
I've been breaking walls down as a blocker in the first half, and I'm going to break them down as a jammer, and that's what she's doing.
Freight Train is just like a wrecking ball. You can't stop her.
She's got fantastic balance, great footwork. Love watching the Freight Train go, and good presence of mind to call that off. She got a couple points, but Merchant of Menace was flying into that pack. 134-79, 13 minutes, 30 seconds to go in this bout.
You know what? When this bout started, I didn't expect to see Freight Train jam, or at least not as frequently as she is, and it's certainly being an asset to Houston right now.
Oh, fantastic adjustment by Houston, because that's really helped with that power blocker position that Atlanta's used so effectively to set up their walls. Paula Seidel, Brandy Brown, and both of them pushing that pack. And Hollisidal wins that one amazingly, because it was a 4-on-2 pack advantage for Houston. So Hollisidal with Brandy Brown digging in, trying to reel her in. Hollisidal looks around, says, can I get any points before Brandy hits the pack? And she does, but Brandy,
oh,
I got to tell you.
She allowed some. Oh, she picked up three, but allowed four. Houston came out on top in that jam. Squeaked those in there.
That was a fantastic job by Brandy Brown. She was the leading scorer up until Death by Chocolate went crazy in the second half. Brandy Brown had a great first half, showing it again. Jamunition with 37 points so far. She's up against Beverly Kills, and Kills has taken a lot of jam returns, Joe, but really struggled. She has not scored the kind of points that Houston wanted her to score today.
Now Atlanta's swarming offense has been very effective at shutting her down.
That's right, and that time is just Jamunition's pure speed that helped her get through the pack, as we got a 3-on-2 pack situation. So
Beverly Kills is going to try and keep the pressure on, try and force her to call it off here. Trading a little paint here, going into turn three and four. Excuse me, that's turns one and two. I'm disoriented. I don't know what's going on.
That's right. I don't know about you, Joe, but I'm used to sitting on the other side
of
it. I've been doing that all day as well. So hopefully our fans at home are able to follow along. 137-83, Atlanta in the lead.
All the more reason to upgrade to the visual feed. $12 will get you all the action, and you can actually see it, so you don't have to rely on us to tell you where it's happening.
All right, no regrets on the line for Atlanta in the red. Death by Chocolate doing some fancy spins and dance moves, picking her spot, and there she goes, and she's done it several times tonight. She's got an opening on the inside, but Wild Cherry cuts it off. Agent Mulder working her. Meanwhile, no regrets struggling in the back of that pack with Wendigo and the rest of the Houston blockers, but now she's got some room, but she runs into the pivot for Houston, and Wendigo able to step up and recycle her a little bit. No regrets showing some speed, and she's through into lead jammer, and that swarming defense finally able to solve the riddle that is Death by Chocolate in the second half. So Atlanta going for that pack control. They've slowed it to a crawl. Nora flies in there, bounces off the Houston skater, and has to call it off to Death by Chocolate.
Oh, Death by Chocolate picked up three again. Houston sneaks in those points at the end and comes out ahead of Atlanta in that jam. That's pretty awesome. Houston never giving up, and that's one of those things. Sometimes you'll see jammers who at the end of a jam, you'll see them raise up and slow down sometimes when they know the jam's almost over. And these Houston girls are not having any of that.
You got to say, there's been 7 points in the last four jams purely from playing to the fourth whistle. And big props to Houston for that. Merchant of Menace, however, pushing and shoving. She's got two blockers to beat at the front. One of them is the Freight Train. She gets around the train, and she's through.
The Merchant of Menace, 66 points so far in this bout.
And a whole lot of them on Grand Slams.
And she's still got 9 minutes or so, almost 10 minutes to continue to score here. 4 points this time. Merchant of Menace now at 70 points. Just an incredible day so far for Merchant of Menace.
Hollis Idol on the line against Beverly Kills.
Beverly Kills has 14 points of her own. Hollis Idol with 28 so far today.
These two have matched up a number of times. And of all the Houston jammers, I think I got to say Mistilla and Beverly Kills are the ones that have struggled the most with this Atlanta defense. And they've got her pushed out of bounds once again. And a bit of a high block there on Agent Mulder. But she's able to reset and push the jammer out again. Going nowhere is Beverly Kills. Meanwhile, Hollis Idol with only two to beat, but they are a formidable two. That's number 360, the Angie Christ. And, of course, number 16, Miss Dilla.
Beverly Kills on the inside as the lead jammer.
You've got to give that to the Angie Christ and to Miss Dilla because they single-handedly held back Hollis Idol until Beverly Kills was able to deal with that defense.
Nice spin move there. But the pack quickly catches back up to her. I thought she was clear there for a second, but
the spin kept her on her feet, but it slowed her down enough that
sure did.
Pack was able to absorb her back in. However, Houston does get a grand slam out of that one, something they desperately needed. It's still a 52-point lead for Atlanta with 8 minutes to go on the clock. Jammunition on the line against Death by Chocolate. You're seeing Chocolate taking a whole lot of jam rotations. She's got 40 points herself. Why not?
Yeah, she's doing an excellent job. Certainly the easily the highest point scorer for Houston today.
And it looks like we've got a 4-on-4 pack. Everybody out there for this party. Jammunition worked that inside line, but getting nowhere. The whole pack just pushing forward. Death by Chocolate now gets some space. But that space soon becomes occupied by Queen Luz Yatifah and Belle of the Brawl, Ozzy Kamikaze on her. We're going to have an out-of-play situation in a second, but Belle gets a hip on her. Jammunition going nowhere. Wendigo having a fantastic game today for Houston, holding back the opposing team's jammer. They haven't been doing it often, Houston has, but when they have, it's been Wendigo at the center of it. Oh, as Jammunition reached for a whip from Alas Insane, the freight train came and rolled her over. However, Death by Chocolate down heavily at the jam line, and as the pack doesn't move forward fast enough, she calls it off. 6 minutes, 50 seconds to go. Four more points for Death. The deficit now 49. Houston clawing back. 6 minutes, Joe. 6 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Time.
Yeah, time is definitely their biggest enemy right now, but they have fought tooth and nail to claw away at that lead.
And the Atlanta fans listening on WFTDA.TV and watching on WFTDA.TV are probably going crazy. They're probably on the edge of their seats with 6 minutes to go. We got No Regrets. We got Brandi Brown. Brown having to go back around, try it again after getting knocked out by Wild Cherry. However, going nowhere is No Regrets, as she's got two, one of them being Mistilla, who's doing a great job in the pivot position to work over Nora. She's getting a lot of help there from Rebel Ann, but at the back of the pack, there's the swarm, Joe.
There it is. That's been such an effective strategy, and I would think that a lot of the other teams and coaches are watching this right now, thinking about tomorrow.
Right.
Going to try and calculate a way to counteract that swarm. I don't know if you can defeat it every time, but they've got to figure out a way to punch holes in it.
That's right. On a nice takeout by number 21, Jekyll and Heidi. Nora finally able to recover from that, bounces up. So a minute into this jam, we finally got our jammers through on their initial pass. But the abuse that went on, and you just saw Mistilla take the jammer star. She is now your jammer for Houston, as we had the star pass from Brandi Brown.
Houston mixing it up at this point. Sometimes you gotta throw a curveball in there.
And nice job by Houston. Mistilla in that pivot position. Of course, we see her jam a lot. She took the panty pass cleanly in that pack and was able to catch up to No Regrets. So she only put one point on the board. The problem for Houston, Joe.
And the score now stands Atlanta 144, Houston 94. And we've got an official timeout. We've got about 4 minutes 40 seconds left in this second half. So we're getting down to the nitty-gritty now.
We are, and the nitty-gritty is the championships coming up in Atlanta in November 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. Why not talk directly to thousands of Derby fans? Advertise on WFTDA.tv. Affordable packages are available for your business, your boot camp, or any kind of tournament advertising. Visit WFTDA.com/sponsors/opportunities to learn more.
That's a great way for your business to reach your target audience.
I got to think there's probably going to be over 100,000 people tuning in for that championship weekend from around the world.
You're going to get out. Your advertising dollar is going to go a long way if you jump on board with the WFTDA.
If I remember correctly, the stats from last year were phenomenal. They were approaching that six-figure viewership over the whole weekend of people logging on and watching the broadcast. And so we encourage you, get your name out there, talk to WFTDA, and get some sponsorship. All right, we're just about ready to go. 4 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Hollis Seidel on the line. Merchant of Menace taking the intentional minor. And Beverly kills for Houston. I think I got it all out, Joe.
There we go. We're up to speed, and so is Beverly Kills trying to make her way through the inside.
Hollis Seidel working the outside.
And that's going to work out as she jukes to the inside on turn four. Hollis Seidel is the lead jammer. Atlanta.
Betty Watchett for Houston went for a big hit here in turn number four, and Hollis Seidel's able to sidestep her, and that's all she needed for lead jammer status. Beverly Kills. She's going home with a few souvenirs from the Atlanta girls tonight as they have hit her hard and hit her often. And both skaters getting two. It's one thing that Hollis Seidel and the Atlanta girls have struggled with tonight is calling that jam off at a timely point. However, they want to burn as much time off the clock,
right.
So it hasn't hurt them, luckily.
Right, yeah, they've certainly got enough of a cushion that it's not going to hurt Atlanta.
So with a 50-point lead late in this second half, can Atlanta hold on and visit the winner of No Coast, our host, and KC, which is coming up a little later today? Jamunition. She's juking, she's jiving, she's spinning around on the inside as she gets knocked out by the freight train. Freight train got to be an MVP for Houston. She's blocked, she's jammed, she's done it all, and now she's working on Jamunition.
She's a Jill of all trades.
However, look at, oh, just getting through there. The swarm was around Death by Chocolate, and one of them fell down, and she was able to use that to her advantage. She's your lead jammer.
Yeah, that's the best way to counteract the swarm is to just avoid it altogether if you can. Prevention is the best medicine, because once you get caught in that, it is so difficult. They will sandwich you in there and
that's
keep
right.
you trapped.
And they've been driving the skaters to the inside or the outside occasionally and just eventually shoving them out of bounds. 146 to 96, 2 minutes and 25 seconds to go. No Regrets on the line for Atlanta. We're waiting for Houston as they've got the timeout right now. Another big thank to our following WFTDA.TV partners, Blood and Thunder Magazine, Derbyology, Derby Life, Derby for All, Derby Skins, Fast Girl Skates, Five Stride, Jammer Up, and Wicked Skatewear. Couldn't do this without those lovely sponsors. 2 minutes and 28 seconds to go in this half, 146 to 100. We're getting a clarification from our referee liaison on something. Houston's still in the timeout. They only got one left. Atlanta has not used any of their timeouts. They haven't had to with this 46-point lead.
Okay, so basically what happened, Miss Dilla, before the star pass, picked up a penalty as pivot. But, you know, you can't really undo that once the jam is over. They figured out she should have had a penalty served, so they sent her to the box. So that's kind of the long and the short of it. That's the Crib Notes version.
Excellent. Well handled by our referee crew. And out there is Big Bad Voodoo Dolly, her first jam of the second half up against Merchant Menace. Oh, Menace tried that inside line but got cut off by 1X Rebel Ann. So everybody's going to try it again. Big Bad Voodoo Dolly for Houston, getting locked down in the back behind Ozzy Kamikaze. Merchant of Menace is clear with 2 minutes to go. This could put the final nail in the coffin, Joe.
At least Houston, I think at this point, is probably very happy that they passed the 100-point mark.
Against that defense, yes. And
oh, a lot of speed there in that hit.
Big Bad Voodoo Dolly just crashed into that pack. Queen Lujatifa off to the penalty box. Merchant of Menace not calling this one. She's content to burn the clock. Big Bad Voodoo Dolly all over the track, doing everything she can to get through that defense. Ooh, and a hard hit. Rebel Ann goes down. Looks like she is okay.
And that's four more points for Atlanta. Merchant of Menace now at 74 points on her own here.
She's going for a few more and trying to burn that clock with 44 seconds left on the jam clock. 1 minute to go in this second half. My friends and fans back in Atlanta watching on WFTDA.TV got to be going crazy now, because Atlanta is going to be going on to the next round. They have knocked off the number three seed, or they will in just under a minute. Houston still battling, though. She only got some fight in them, but...
And five in the sky, another grand slam for Atlanta.
79 points for the Merchant. She is like a robot out there, Joe. I mean, really, just that same skating stride, doing her job, skating around, letting the jam go out.
Well, Atlanta is looking like a well-oiled machine as it is, just functioning in the ways that they need to function here.
And showing some great fitness. I got to think, if you're KC or Omaha, whomever's going to meet them in the next round, you got to be taking some notes right now.
Well, I have to be honest with you. I'll be frank here. With these tournaments, or not necessarily just the playoff tournaments, but any tournament in general, when you see a team outside that has skaters smoking in between the games, they're not the ones that win the tournaments. You know, it's that training, it's that dedication to a healthy lifestyle that gives you that competitive edge when you get to these playoffs.
Absolutely. These girls are athletes 100%. And when you see them in the physical development of their bodies over these last few years, the moves that they've been able to put on.
Yeah.
And, you know, you don't see too many professional athletes, like you say, having a smoke before or after the boat. And
the numbers of the skaters that do that dwindle each year. With each tournament, it seems there are less and less participants.
So 26 seconds to go in this one. No regrets up against Beverly Kills. And my apologies, it's No Coast going up against Kansas City, not Omaha. Omaha is taking on Texas Roller Girls right after this one. So KC No Coast will meet Atlanta in the next round. But Atlanta one step closer to punching their ticket to home, to the championships, by beating Houston here. And they got lead jammer status. It's no regrets one more time. She got 8 seconds to burn off this clock. And Atlanta's going to do it. Wild Cherry just sidestepping, giving a little shove into Beverly Kills. And one last hit by number 19 for Houston. And that is it, Joe.
And it's over. The Atlanta Roller Girls looking really, really good in this one. 165, Houston 104.
And the Dirty South Derby Girls, their motto is taking it to the streets. That's exactly what they did, Joe. It was physical, it was defense, and they took it to Houston.
They did. I guess this is our big upset for day one. So if you did your bracket based on just the seeding alone, your bracket is already shot.
That's right. And there's probably a whole lot of people in Atlanta that had picked their home team to beat Houston. Everybody's been cheering for them back there. But, you know, definitely when coming as the sixth seed against the third seed, as improved as Atlanta was, there was a whole lot up in the air. But they delivered.
Yeah, Atlanta looking really strong.
Chip Queso here, joined with Merchant of Menace from the Atlanta Roller Girls. They just came off of a big win over Houston, 104 for Houston, 165 for Atlanta. 84 points, Merchant. You were on fire. Definitely put the team on your back. Do you feel like you have to put the team on the back?
No, not at all. I think that most of my points came because my pack was just holding the other jammer. You know, I mean, I can't do it without them, obviously. So.
Absolutely. Now, you've been to the regionals the last 4 out of 5 years. And trying to get back to the championships. A little different this year since you guys are hosting championships. What's different about the team or the approach so that you guys can try to get to your home crowd next month?
Well, I mean, obviously we're really motivated. We've never actually made it to champs, and so the fact that it's in Atlanta this year is, you know, just extra incentive. It's really exciting. We've been practicing harder than ever. We actually have 3-hour practices in an unconditioned warehouse, which we've never done before. So in Atlanta, you can imagine they're pretty tough circumstances. We've had some amazing additions to our team mid-season. They've really kind of reinvigorated us. We're just, you know, super excited and just really, really driven to go this year. So we're working hard.
Awesome. Well, you obviously started off in the right foot. Again, beating Houston, you've still got quite a few hills to climb, if you will.
Yeah.
Anything coming out of this game, because you can't celebrate too long, that you want to take to your team for the next bout upcoming?
Obviously we learn from every team we play. I think we've played Houston actually in our first game the last 2 years, so I knew they were tough, but I think they were even tougher than I expected. They recycled really, really well, so I think that's something for us to work on, both stopping that recycling and, you know, trying to implement that ourselves as well, obviously just learn from our opposition. And then just, you know, keep holding those amazing walls that my pack was holding today and, you know, see what we can do.
There you go, to see if you can get back. Well, we're here on WFTDA.TV. I'm Chip Queso, but that is the Merchant of Menace. And great bout. Congratulations. Stick around. Stick with us. We've got Texas upcoming versus Omaha. Lots of derby action. Thank you for being here, Merchant. Good luck in the next bout.
Thank you.
And stick around. We'll be right back.